You know, I need not tell you, Gordon, because you know I'm telling the truth. Everything I say always comes to the top. Gordon, I am going all the way with...
Can I turn your back on?
You can't turn your back on Don Morocco, Ole Anderson, Stan Hansen, and a host of others because they don't know what it is to go one-on-one. Morocco, you got to see me one-on-one. You got to look in my eye one-on-one. And knowing that this is a man that's on his... way back to what belongs to him, Ric Flair's world's heavyweight title around my waist once more.
Okay, we're going to take a look at a situation that occurred not too terribly long ago involving this man, Don Morocco. So let's go to this match at this time. And that is, of course, the superstar going up against Terry Gibbs. One fall, 10-minute time limit. And waiting now for... All right, that's Gibbs moving out very quickly against the superstar. The superstar making final last-minute judgments. They circle, they meet collar and elbow. It's superstar Bullen Gibbs back into the ring ropes. Gibbs... This athlete caught in a hip lock takedown, but Gibbs very quickly turns that to his own advantage into a head scissors. And so the superstar is caught. The superstar float up once again. He's caught with a head scissors. And there you see Mr. Wrestling 2, whom we'll be seeing in action later on in the program. And he is at ringside as usual when the superstar is out there. Not only a physical war going on between these two men, but a psychological war as well. Collar and elbow once again. Gibbs now with a side headlock. And it's Gibbs again with the side headlock. The superstar. Gibbs blocked it very nicely. The superstar was trying to hook him on that, and Gibbs blocked it very nicely, brought him over, and has him in the side headlock at this point in time. Referee Nick Patrick watching him carefully, and so the superstar in trouble, and of course Wrestling 2 continues to sit outside the ring watching with a great deal of interest. Oh, and you get 2-2 again. Impassive, not moving, not interfering in any way, but it has a disturbing effect on the superstar, no question about it. Gibbs keeping the side headlock. Gibbs has thus far in the match pretty well stayed out front. The superstar now utilizing the ring ropes forces a break, and the superstar outside the ring. And so, obviously, the superstar somewhat frustrated. Count is on. Gibbs is eager to get to his man. Superstar moves back into the ring. Once again, back to the ropes. And there was the superstar uncorking on the break and catching Gibbs, driving him back to the canvas once again. Snap mare that puts Gibbs to the canvas into a rear chin lock. Again, Nick Patrick checking carefully. And the superstar making comments about wrestling two outside. There, the superstar getting some extra leverage that time. Up into a top wrist lock, and it is Gibbs mounting more pressure on the superstar. And the superstar had an opportunity there, using his weight and strength, was able to push Gibbs back to the ropes, caught him on the break, catches him once again. And this is where Gibbs is going to have to be a little more cautious. And Gibbs hurtled out to the concrete. And the superstar now beginning to punish the side of the head of the superstar. Off the rope, caught him beautifully right at the belt line. Catches him once again. And the superstar, wait a minute, the superstar down and outside the ring. And the superstar more than somewhat unnerved at the presence of Mr. Wrestling number two. Stoically seated at ringside. And Gibbs, of course, anxious to charge in, anxious to get a pinfall or a submission hold if he can over this man. Superstar, using a headbutt that time, drove Gibbs back to the canvas. Double thrust into the throat now that has Gibbs back down on his back, and Gibbs powers out before the count of three. It is a neckbreaker by the superstar. And again, Gibbs powers out before the count, and now the superstar back to the rear chin lock. Gibbs caught in the midsection. Superstar Gibbs ducked away. Gibbs catches him, cross body block. And the superstar almost pinned that time by Terry Gibbs in a snap mare. As the superstar back to the canvas, and it's Gibbs after the mask. Gibbs after the mask of the superstar. Ooh. The superstar caught him, and he started to go outside the ring, and there was Wrestling 2 on his feet. And the superstar.
Let's look to think when there's two guys out there.
The superstar complaining about presence that he has counted out. The superstar complaining about the presence of Mr. Wrestling number two and has left the area using...
I'll tell you... You see, it's just like I explained to you before, the man, when it gets down tough and gets hard, he finds an exit to run. Well, you know, it's going to be a time that he's going to be in a position where he can't run, and that time is drawing near.
Well, Gordon, I don't see any reason why he should run on me. I gave him a fair match. Mr. Wrestling didn't interfere in the match. And I gave it all I had. And I think that he also has a fear for Terry Gibbs also.
Well, I'll tell you what, he found the entire situation extremely unnerving. And as you said, if there are a way to keep him in the ring or put him back in the ring, that may solve a lot of problems.
You know, Gordon, there's ways of keeping people in the ring, and there's one coming up his way.
Thank you so very much. Terry, pleasure at this time to introduce both Brad Armstrong, the Rookie of the Year, and the Vice President in charge of promotions for Championship Wrestling, Jerry Briscoe. And Jerry has a most impressive award to pass along.
Well, Gordon, we've been watching this young man for some time now, and Brad Armstrong has come on. He's truly earned this award. His father is proud of him, and I'm sure Brad is proud, and it just gives me a great pleasure to honor the United States heavyweight, junior heavyweight champion, Brad Armstrong. by awarding him the Rookie of the Year trophy. Brad.
Thank you very much. Thank you. That's all. I'd just like to say thank you very much, Mr. Briscoe. You know, I finally realized how Dad felt in 1968 when he won the Rookie of the Year award, and I just want to say thank you very much to everybody involved, and even the people who aren't involved. I just want to say thank you. I don't think I could have done it by myself. I think these people out here had a lot to do with staying behind me, and I really appreciate it.
Fair enough, Brad. Certainly our congratulations as well. And, Jerry, I know, of course, that you've been doing an awful lot of traveling lately in the Virginias, Ohio, Michigan, and you've certainly brought back a lot of interesting information from a lot of great wrestling fans.
Well, I have Gordon Charlie Patrick up in West Virginia. He sends his...
And just like I said, there's a lot of things going on. Roddy Piper, you know, he's been running his mouth. Now then it's been closed. You know, that maybe ain't my choice. And just a lot of things going on.
Well, of course, obviously, you're keeping your eye on Rick.
Well, yeah, that's for sure, Gordon. And like I heard, Rick beat Bobby Backlund. Well, that ain't the truth, the upper hand at the time, you know. So, Flair.
Well, that's a fact. There was no victor in that match.
Just a second. We're both dressed as men here. We can talk man to man with no problem. You got a nice brown suit on, nice black shoes. That's all right, Mr. Rich. We can talk. We don't want no trouble. All I'm saying to you is I don't know anything about that. If both men got counted out, but I'll tell you something, Mr. Tommy Rich. When it comes to me, that's the difference, you see, because I'm right about what I do, Mr. Tommy Rich. And here's $5,000. Put them in your meaty mitts right there. There's $5,000 for killing Dusty Rhodes. 25 seconds. Dusty Rhodes is completely finished. There's $5,000 right there. Oh, but maybe you should be worried, because I can understand, because I got all kinds of money, and I don't particularly like you at all, although I can stand you like a man.
I don't want to interrupt. No, just like he said, we're going to do a gentleman style.
Yeah.
You know, you're out here flaunting your money.
Yeah.
And saying, you know, you're pretty confident.
Yeah, I am.
You think Dusty Rhodes is gone?
Yes, I know he's gone.
Well, I got news for you, brother. He'll be back.
He'll be back.
Well, gentlemen, if you remember last week, I made comment that we would make an announcement this week about a special referee.
A special referee.
Andre the Giant. Well, can you imagine about 260 pounds of the American Dream?
What do you mean? I knocked him out. 25 seconds, he was on his back. Rich was laying right next to him. They were sleeping together. They were roommates. Uh-huh. What are you talking about?
You finished him.
He was on his chair.
He was on the chair.
He was down. You want to hurt people. You want to see people get hurt. You're talking about hurt. You want to talk about hurt.
You want to see hurt.
Yeah, we're...
$10,000. $10,000, he finishes. Rhodes and Rich, you just look at him. $10,000, mister.
Well, there you heard it, and it is Morocco moving out against Charlie White, and Morocco just... he is absolutely demolishing this man. It is Morocco punishing White, and I do mean punishing White. Morocco now with a neck breaker on White has him down to the canvas and did not allow the pin. Morocco has him, and it's Morocco hurtling White into the referee, and the referee is double. Paul Arndorf offering some aid here to the referee, was caught low in the abdomen. Wait a second, Paul Arndorf. Arndorf now, wait a minute. Arndorf is taking matters into his own hands now. And it's Arndorf taking the place of Nick Patrick, who got caught low in the abdomen that time. And it is Arndorf in there now officiating, and I'll guarantee you this much. There will be some justice, I'll tell you. And it's Arndorf stopping Morocco. And you've got a standoff between those two. Morocco moves in against, and White gets the side headlock. Morocco, a belly-to-back souple. And White coming up rather slowly now as Morocco catches him once again. It is Morocco. White trying to get to his feet, and it's Morocco moving back after him once again. Caught him with an elbow. Orndorff watching carefully, making sure that... Well, he had a three count. He had a three count. There's no question about that. And Orndorff not raising at... Well, in a strangely somber, quiet...
They want to die, Johnson! They want to get in the way! Look at that! They all want to be around. They all... Everybody see Magnuson's come down. Everybody see that happen. Dusty Rhodes, you're only fit to be a referee. You're only fit. Tommy Rich, like I told you, you're going to be lying right next to Dusty Rhodes. You're going to be lying. You're going to be out. Right in the Omni tomorrow.
Tomorrow night at the Omni, Dusty Rhodes will, in fact...
I hope so.
Yeah, well, you can count on it. I'll guarantee you that. And see you this much that... Wrestling 2 caught him as Buzz Sawyer charged him. He was wrestling 2. High backdrop on Buzz Sawyer. And there you see the superstar cheering him on. And wait a minute. The superstar. He just grabbed Wrestling 2's robe. Took it off, what's he doing? Oh, man. Oh, just a moment here. He's destroying Private. No, this. Oh, come on. Buzz Sawyer and Wrestling 2 battling it out. I don't think Wrestling 2 is even aware of what's happened to him. He is now. Wrestling 2 just made a beeline for the superstar. And it was, Wrestling 2 catching, and look at Superstar has demolished. Oh, this is terrible. I don't know. There's no way that the superstar can in any way justify this sort of thing. And Wrestling 2 completely unnerved by what's going on.
Think about that, Gordon. Let the great legend think about that.
Well, I'll guarantee you one thing. That's the most despicable thing I have ever seen in my entire lifetime, to take somebody's property.
Let me tell you something. Superstar, let me tell you something. This is one time, pal. You overstepped yourself. There's a lot of guys in line to wrestle you. But let me tell you, I'm no two anymore. I'm one, pal. I'm number one. And everybody, anywhere, is going to have to follow me. Because you're mine. I got you. I've got you in a match, pal. One you can't escape from me. You're mine. Your body. And your soul is mine! Superstar! Superstar, you're mine!
Here, so was his father in 1968. Who really cares?
I never, honestly, never had any animosity for sweet little Tommy Rich. Cute little Tommy Rich. I like to hold him on my knee and kiss him sometimes. He looks so cute. Never had any animosity towards the guy. Never cared about the NWA really that much. Have always been an outlaw all my life. As far as I'm concerned, I still got $5,000 coming because Dusty Rhodes is still on his fat you-know-what and is still jiggling from his sitting down a half hour ago and never stopped shaking. He's doing just what he should be doing. Now, Tommy Rich. See, I may be left alone. See, I may be by myself, but it doesn't matter. Because I've been alone before. I got 10 grand coming. I got 10 grand coming on Tommy Rich. And Tommy Rich says, okay, I'm going to get Fatso, and he's going to be referee. One night, him and I got a bottle of whiskey, and we got all brave together. Big deal. I've been brave, and I've been strong, and I came to the Superstation not to be a superstar, because I was a superstar long before I came to any Superstation. Dusty Rhodes, if you know what I'm talking about, I'll go anywhere to find you. I said that. I would have done it for free, but I got 5 grand coming, you see. And I got another 5 grand. Cute little Tommy Rich wants a piece of magnificence, wants a piece of the action, wants a piece of what's happening, you see.
Well, I'll tell you what he's talking about in case you happen to miss it.
I'm talking. Go ahead.
Earlier, in another hour, we had a situation where I...
put in the empty head. He decides that he wants to become a referee. He's not good enough as a wrestler because he won't put his title up against Morocco. He says, and he jumps in the ring. Now, let's see what happens.
One fall, 10-minute time limit. Roy Rogers out of Waco, Texas, moving up against Chick Donovan. Rogers at about 219 pounds. We've seen him in action before, but the first time to see him in live action here on Championship Wrestling. I understand man comes with some outstanding credentials, but he's going up against a very tough man. Good duck under, go behind by Donovan, and a standing switch by Rogers, and Rogers... rode him to the canvas, keeps the ride going. And it's Donovan trying to sit out and trying to escape. And Rogers keeps an excellent ride moving on Chick Donovan. So the Golden Boy finding a problem and trying to get away from Mr. Rogers. He tried the lateral press a bit early going for that pinning combination, particularly that application. All right, good clean step back, good clean break by Rogers. Nice to see another one of our official sports photographers, Gene Gordon, back in action today after a lengthy time off while he underwent some major surgery. Nice to see him back in action and going 110% again. Donovan, forearm across the chest now of Rogers. Could have Rogers stunned on that one off the rope. And it was Donovan hooking him into a full body slam. Donovan crashes down. Rogers rolls to one side. Arm drag by Rogers. Inside arm bar by Rogers now. And Rogers beginning to retaliate on the Golden Boy, Chick Donovan. It's Rogers continuing to punish Donovan. Rogers again drives the knee into the biceps and triceps of Chick Donovan. And so Rogers has been very selective thus far, has been concentrating on that left arm. Moving against a point of attack, a point of balance. And Donovan, who is in tremendous physical condition, taking a lot of punishment, now giving some punishment as he jammed Rogers back to the turnbuckle. And he's got his own problems with that left arm, but he's using that right arm effectively. He's trying to get circulation back into that arm again. But you can see the effectiveness of Rogers' attack on that arm. And Donovan again using the right arm, but that left arm still giving him trouble. No, he does not have full strength back in it, nor full use of it. And now a snap mirror that has Rogers back to the canvas. Lateral press hooks the far leg. Rogers powers out. You can hear the crowd picking it up. Let's go, Roy.
Let's go!
And it's Donovan now trying to keep that chin lock on Rogers. Rogers dropped to the canvas again. And it's Donovan now snap marrying. Almost had him. Near fall for, and Rogers explodes to the midsection. Donovan retaliates. Now Donovan, a snap mare on Rogers into a rear chin lock. Rogers trying to break that hold, but Donovan clamping down, driving Rogers back to the canvas. And Mr. Rogers finds himself in a predicament here. Rear chin lock, and it's Rogers trying to battle his way out. Donovan keeps the pressure on. Notice the way referee Nick Patrick is right in there, checking to see if the throat area was being violated by the arm of Donovan. It was not, and now Rogers using the elbow. Donovan rips across the eyes. Good reversal that time by Rogers. Wow, did he catch him right across the cheekbone. That drove Donovan off his feet, stunned him, and he caught him again, and Donovan in trouble now. He's back on his heels, no question about it. A backdrop that has Donovan came down partially on one shoulder, and Donovan in a lot of trouble. Rogers charges him. Reverse Nelson hooks the leg and scored the pinfall. And so, Rogers, let's take a look at that again in slow motion. Vice President in charge of promotions for Championship Wrestling is with us right now with quite an announcement.
Well, Tito Santana, outstanding wrestler, Gordon. Something I'd like to make my announcement with. You know, appearing on Georgia Championship Wrestling goes worldwide. It means an awful lot of money for the wrestlers appearing here on Georgia Championship Wrestling. Two wrestlers that have been suspended for a week is Stan Hansen and Ole Anderson. They will not be appearing on TV this week. They have been suspended.
Well, Jerry, I've got, according to my format, I've got Ole Anderson and Stan Hansen scheduled to wrestle here in the very next match.
Well, Gordon, I hate to inform you, but that format is wrong. They will not be appearing here as a tag team. They will not wrestle on Georgia Championship Wrestling this week. Thank you.
Okay, there you have it. The word from Jerry Briscoe. We'll see what happens next, and we'll find out right after we pause.
Who Briscoe thinks he's kidding. I don't know where Hansen is, but I know this. You're not going to stop Ole Anderson. We got our belts back, and Sawyer and I are going to go in the ring, and we're going to wrestle.
Well, okay. I guess we're going to see Ole Anderson and Buzz Sawyer going up against Kevin Sullivan. And wait a second. Wait a second. Jerry Briscoe and Nick Patrick just went out there. They're informing Charlie Smith.
What are you talking about? Who are you talking to?
Well, he has apparently told Anderson on no uncertain terms. Well, he has been suspended on television, not anywhere else that he may be wrestling, but he has been suspended on television. But any other place he has a contract, in arenas, auditoriums, and what have you, he can wrestle. But it was pretty obvious that Jerry Briscoe made that rather emphatic, and so we've got Kevin Sullivan going up against Buzz Sawyer in a single match, and what a match it ought to be. This ought to be something indeed. Sullivan and Sawyer. One fall. And Mr. Anderson, I assume, understands what you meant business, Jerry.
Well, Mr. Anderson will go to get his attorney. He'll go get anybody he wants, Gordon. But I've taken the liberty to ask the director to show a piece of film that we have. Bobby Simmons conducting an interview in Michigan where I can show you reason and justification for the suspension, Gordon.
Okay, fair enough. We'll take a look at that as time permits a little bit later on. Right now, though, Kevin Sullivan out there with Buzz Sawyer. Sullivan catches him a beautiful shoulder smash coming off the rope. Hits Sullivan up and over his man, a leapfrog by Sawyer. Sawyer tried to set him, and Sullivan was one step ahead. Sullivan, a step ahead and a beautiful hip lock takedown by Sullivan. Sawyer tried to roll that to his own advantage. I've said this before, Jerry, but when you get Sullivan and Sawyer in there, a lot of people are fast, they're sudden.
Well, they're extremely quick athletes. They keep themselves in tremendous condition all the time. It's what Georgia Championship Wrestling is all about, Gordon, is great athletes like these two young men.
And I might also mention, as we saw, the two top contenders for the NWA World Heavyweight Championship, Tommy Wildfire Rich and Paul Orndorff. We had on the air a little earlier, and of course you take the likes of such an outstanding young competitor as Tito Santana, and you are seeing the very optimum wrestling competition, and right now Buzz Sawyer using that forearm most effectively against the chest of Kevin Sullivan. Sullivan with a reversal, and the Boston Battler caught him one right over the heart with a hard right hand back into a side headlock. I know there was some confusion regarding the World Tag Team Championship, but those belts have been returned to Ole Anderson and Stan Hansen, and the suspension that you're talking about is for today on television. It has nothing to do with any other contracts they have.
That's right. They will be able to compete in your local arenas wherever they're scheduled and sign contracts to appear, Gordon. But for today on television, on nationwide TV, where these wrestlers receive great sum of monetary refund for their further actions on TV. Anderson and Hansen are suspended from TV today.
I have it once again. I just wanted to clarify that point, and it is again Buzz Sawyer now, as Sullivan in trouble, and it's Sullivan firing back to the midsection. Snap mare by Sawyer. Take Sullivan to the canvas into a rear chin lock. And Sullivan's upper body beginning to show the marks of this battle already. You get two such outstanding athletes in the physical condition they're in. They have been going at it hammer and tong now for several minutes, nonstop, and it is Sawyer. Perhaps just a little bit desperate now, taking some shortcuts and using that right hand. Sawyer tying Sullivan up in the ring ropes and has the pressure to him now. Charlie Smith, the referee, trying to get him separated. It's Sullivan lashing out with a foot, and now Sullivan with a forearm to the side of the head of Buzz Sawyer. Outside the ring. And it's now the two of them battling away outside the way. A pier sixer going here. Sawyer smashed into the... Wait a minute, the time limit, the both men outside of the ring, both men outside the ring, and they are continuing to... And Anderson started to go to the ring and was told very quickly that there'd be an additional $500 fine. Both men counted out. Both men counted out of the ring. And so neither man is victorious. Both of them wanting to continue up in the man himself. And until he tells me officially he's the national heavyweight champion, Paul Orndorff, but I understand that you returned this belt back. Why?
It's very good, Gordon. It's officially handed back. It belongs to Georgia Championship Wrestling. I went to the Georgia Promotions. I went to the president of the NWA. They've been notified you've got the belt. And the reason is, you know, in different places that I've been, a lot of the fans, they say, well, Paul, if you don't win the world's heavyweight belt, you always got the national heavyweight belt. Well, I want to erase that out of everybody's mind. And most of all, I don't want to have to worry about it, because I am after one thing and one thing only, and that's that world heavyweight belt. Now, I'm very serious about it, Flair, and I hope you're out there listening. I've never been more damn serious in my life, baby, because it was very hard. It was very hard for me to give up this belt, the most prestigious belt I've ever earned in my years of being a professional wrestler. It was the hardest thing I've ever had to do. But let me tell you something. That world belt is the ultimate. It's the thing. It's what everybody talks about, the world's heavyweight champion. And that's exactly what I'm coming for, Gordon. The belt is back to Georgia Championship Wrestling. I'm going in. I'm going to do my job. Flair, be ready, baby.
Paul Orndorff. Boy, you talk about a man with single-minded determination. He's got it.
Jim, or a telephone would begin to ring. My little girl ran and answered the phone. She said, Dad, somebody's on the phone. And I snatched the phone up and they say, Dog, you got a match in Big Atlanta, Georgia against the Super Destroyer. And I left and I signed real quick. I told them, put my name upon that dotted line. But I heard time and time again, different people been jumping into the ring. But I tell you what, it happened when I was playing football. But when I broke into the backfield and I started shaking, I shook until I found that ball. And that's exactly what's going to happen in Atlanta, Georgia, Super D. I don't care if it's Ole Anderson, Stan Hansen, Paul Out, Patient Orndorff, the Samoans, anybody jumping to the ring. Just like I said, those four square circles is the dog yard. And nobody runs the dog out of the dog yard. But anything that gets in that ring, including that referee, put your strap and shirt on, because I'm coming for one reason, and that's put the thump down on somebody hind end.
You know, you mentioned about nobody runs him out of his own yard. Well, dog, you're not in your yard any longer. You're in our yard.
All right, Super Destroyer's in the ring for a few weeks. Nice to have him back with us. He'll be with us during the day. Roddy Piper, welcome aboard.
Well, Mr. Soli, due to popular demand, I sent in an interview here at VTR, and I said, America, put up or shut up. Well, eventually, they finally shut up, and here I am, and they had to conclude, whether they like me or not, Mr. Soli, that I knew what I was talking about. Much the same as yourself, you are the greatest impresario of professional wrestling commentating I have ever seen in my life. I am proud to be back here on Georgia Champion. We have great matches, Mr. Soli, and I'm here to commentate them just with you, palsy-walsy.
Indeed. All right, well, there you see him, Roddy Piper, back with us. Let me take a moment to talk about something that is rather distressing, however. We have a young man who's been competing here recently on championship wrestling by the name of Roy Rogers. We have come to find out, of course, that he, in fact, is not Roy Rogers, that he is a cousin to Tommy Wildfire Rich. And in order not to try and trade on the name of Rich...
I got one thing to say, and Morocco, I'm basing it right at you, brother. You know, you've tried to run over Dusty Rhodes, you tried to run over Tommy Rich, but it's Omni. Brother, you don't mess with family, and you don't mess with mine, Jack.
Yeah, if I may, I'll explain that situation. Rogers had to wrestle as a substitute competitor going up against the magnificent Morocco. It was an excellent match. And Rogers is a young man who didn't want to trade on the name of Rich. He wanted to go out and make his own name, and that's why he chose the name Roy Rogers. As it turns out, he eventually lost the match, but it wasn't that was so bad. It was the fact of what Morocco did after the match.
You know, somebody's here trying to make a name for themselves. I don't know who he thinks he is or what he thinks he is, but Buzz Sawyer's going to show him who he is.
All right, let's go to the ring. Buzz Sawyer going up against Tito Santana. It'll be one fall with a 10-minute time limit. I might point out that the attack on young Johnny Rich, Roy Rogers, his real name is Johnny Rich, a cousin of Tommy Rich, wasn't it? And it is fired down as Santana caught him. Tito Santana going up against Buzz Sawyer. They meet, and a good arm drag takedown now. It's a good arm drag takedown. Sawyer again warning his man. There you see Sawyer. Originally from St. Petersburg, Florida, went on to the Nationals in high school amateur wrestling. Tito Santana, of course, outstanding amateur background. Both of these men, as I've said so many times before, proud young lions in the sport of professional wrestling. A lot of great action upcoming during this next hour, so by all means do stay tuned. Santana off the ropes, and good leapfrog by Sawyer, and Santana caught him a beautiful flying drop kick. Good arm drag takedown once again by Tito Santana. Referee Nick Patrick in there. Nick Patrick, a young fellow, about 205 pounds now, maybe 210, works out, keeps himself in great shape. And I'll tell you, the referees get quite a workout indeed when they're out there maintaining law and order as best they can in the squared circle. Notice Sawyer now coming across the face and mouth of Santana, hampering the breathing slightly, coming off the rope. Good shoulder smash by Santana. Santana. Rolling reverse by Santana has Sawyer down. Sawyer with those powerful legs able to break it up. Another good arm drag takedown by Santana, and so Sawyer has found himself on the receiving end of this situation. Santana now with an inside armbar. Mr. Piper, I would say so far it's been a very even match.
Very even. Santana, you noticed him long and lanky, still with good muscle form. Where Sawyer, he's your more squatty fighter, and it really makes for an interesting fight because they must combat each other in ways they're not used to, you know? And where Santana, I imagine he's been training for squatty fighters, the Joe Frazier kind, where, well, let's just compare him for sake's namesake here, Santana, the Muhammad Ali kind, and what the guy's got to do is to keep Sawyer away. What he's got to do is use them long arms of his. Use them long arms. Keep him away with them long arms. And that way he'll wear him down, but right now he's fighting Sawyer's kind of fight, and I believe that's wrong.
Interesting observation from Roddy Piper. Sawyer does have the lower center of gravity. There's no question about that. Perhaps the slightly more powerful legs, but Santana does have a reach advantage, I feel confident. And it is Sawyer now utilizing those forearms very effectively. Santana retaliating, catching him again and again in the side of the jaw. It is Santana coming back through the ropes now. And Sawyer trying to set him. And it is Santana reversing the situation. And there's where Santana's height and leverage has served him well.
Exactly right, Mr. Sawyer. You are absolutely perfect. He's got three. Oh, I thought he had him there for a second. You're absolutely right. You're absolutely perfect. Now, he did, Santana just did a move there I would not have done. Santana just pushed Sawyer off the pile driver, and then he went for the same kind of motion himself. If Sawyer was thinking right, he would have snappled out that. But such is the matter. He did do so right.
Oh, what a kick. What a kick.
Beautiful thinking on the part of Sawyer as he utilized those ring ropes as a partner, if you will. And caught Santana, drove him down. Now Sawyer taking time, crashes down, but it's Santana rolling to one side. Referee Nick Patrick keeping himself back in a neutral corner.
Perfect. You notice he hurt the leg. What's the first thing Santana does for? He goes for the leg. It sounds malicious. We're out here to win, and that's what these two boys are trying to do. They're both fantastic. They're both trying to come to the top. Look at Santana going right for that leg. Oh, Sawyer pulled him off by the hair there. I would have done the same thing.
Inside step over, and again, Sawyer breaks it up as Santana. Then wait a minute. Sawyer leaving.
Well, he's resting, isn't he?
Sawyer leaving with an injured leg.
What did Sawyer say there?
He said something about Santana being a bit crazy. And, all right. Santana is the victor via the fact that Buzz Sawyer left the ring. So your victor in this first event today on Championship Wrestling, Tito Santana. Mr. Rogers, if I may, I'd like to clarify one point now, if I could. Are we now to refer to you as Roy Rogers or Johnny Rich?
Well, Gordon, my real name is Johnny Ridge. When I started out wrestling, me and Tommy talked it over, and we figured it'd be best if I went under a different name so I could get the experience that I needed in this wrestling, because it is a tough sport. I learn every day, Gordon. But me and Tommy, where we're from in Tennessee, people stick together, family especially. And I've never seen Tommy as mad as he is now. Morocco, buddy, I guarantee you, you're in for a big surprise. Tommy Rich is after you, buddy, and he's going to get you because he's hot. I've never seen him any hotter than he is now, Gordon.
Well, excuse me, Mr. Rich or Mr. Rogers. I had no time thought that I would rouse the ire of little Tommy Rich's cousin. Hey, look, I didn't come here. If I'd have known you were Tommy Rich's cousin, brother, if I'd have known you were Tommy Rich's cousin. There's no reason for that. Let's go to a commercial break right now. There's no reason for this. This is baloney. Yeah, well, you know, it's like this. Mr. Soli is hurt, and I'm not as good a commentator as Mr. Soli, but one thing, you know, hurting Mr. Soli, it's like snapping a pencil. It don't mean nothing, but I'll tell you, ladies and gentlemen, if I got it...
See them in the ring at this time. Tommy Rich getting set to remove his jacket, and the Super Destroyer has removed his tunic, and they're ready to... have at it here. One fall, 10-minute time limit in this first match here today on Championship Wrestling. A up into a top wrist lock at the very onset of the match. Referee Nick Patrick, and so it is the Super Destroyer able to utilize that one to his own advantage. And now, Wildfire ducked under for the takedown. Interesting crowd here today from all over the United States. And we have some good folks from St. Thomas and the Virgin Islands visiting with us. Folks from Ohio, from West Virginia. Of course, a lot of folks from right here in Georgia as well. But interesting to have so many good friends from all over the country here in Atlanta at Super 17. All right, once again. Super Destroyer pressing his advantage on that one now over Tommy Wildfire Rich. Bottom wrist lock, and it was Wildfire Rich reversing that to a top wrist lock. Bear in mind this match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Drop toe hold by the Super Destroyer. Well executed, but could not take advantage of it as Tommy Rich slipped away from that. Collar and elbow into a side headlock by the Super Destroyer. Into a hip lock takedown, back to the canvas. And it's Super Destroyer with the advantage position. Referee Nick Patrick was down there very quickly, cut the two shoulders down momentarily. Wildfire, however, turning to his man, has that right shoulder off the mat. He's in a predicament that would be difficult for the Super Destroyer to score a pinfall from that particular combination. Back to their feet. Rich in the red trunks. The Super Destroyer, of course. Notice the way the Super Destroyer has that side headlock under the cheekbone and drops him with a shoulder smash up and over his man. Reversal that time by the Super Destroyer. Tommy Wildfire Rich breaks it up. Once again, back to a solid takedown by Tommy Wildfire Rich. And out of camera range, but observing everything very carefully is Buzz Sawyer. There you see him watching this match. Of course, there's immediate cause for Sawyer making some comments, obviously, about Tommy Wildfire Rich, and it is Sawyer scouting things and moving around up against the ring ropes now. Super Destroyer now turns... picking it up. Let's go, Tommy. Let's go. And into the turnbuckles. Tommy Wildfire Rich may be having troubles here as the Super Destroyer continues to move on his man. Buzz Sawyer still outside, hurling comments back and forth. And it is Rich breaking it up that time, trying with an elbow to the forehead, and it's Rich now. Super Destroyer reversing on him. Rich caught in a high backdrop that time. Rich is in trouble. Rich in a high arch backdrop. Had to be about 8 feet in the air when he came down, and it is stunned Rich and the Super Destroyer very quickly, taking advantage of it. It appears with a front face lock or possible front chancery. Lateral press. And, well, possible trouble beginning to brew here as I see now. There you see Stan Hansen and Buzz Sawyer out here at ringside, and... Wait a minute, Ole Anderson has just arrived at ringside. And we've got now the superstar coming out to ringside. And things are getting very, very close here. And it is Terry Gordy and Michael Hayes, the favorites. And we've got the ring surrounded with people. Sawyer complaining to me about the Freebirds, but after all, he's here. Tommy Wildfire Rich explodes on the Super Destroyer, catches him in the midsection, gets him to the top of the head. And it's Wildfire Rich with a series of hard right hands. Super Destroyer. And a Super Destroyer caught with a cross body block. He gets out before the count of three, the Super Destroyer leaving the ring. Some hurried strategy here as the Super Destroyer moves back inside, and Tommy Wildfire Rich. Pierce exploding now between these. He misses with a hard right hand, and Tommy Wildfire Rich gets the sleeper hold. Tommy Rich has the sleeper hold on the Super Destroyer. Rolling reverse into a... Wait a minute. Buzz Sawyer charged the ring. Tommy Wildfire Rich and Andre the Giant has suddenly cleared the area. The eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant. Disappear before, but they did. Hanson and Anderson.
They're running like the scared dogs that they are. They're running again, Gordon, but they won't be running for long. As soon as we get them tied up like the pigs that they are, we're going to get them in the cage. I can't wait.
$5,000 can do anything they want.
Fair enough.
$5,000 battle royal, baby. We got the jack. We can get it on now.
Fair enough. We'll be right back. And tag team match. And it is Ole Anderson moving out against Ole Anderson and Stan Hansen against Brad Armstrong and Mr. Wrestling number two. One fall, television time remaining, and Anderson having his hands full now with Brad Armstrong. Brad Armstrong, of course, named Rookie of the Year. Outstanding young athlete. Hip lock takedown. Armstrong gets him in a head scissors very quickly. Hansen in the ring now and using that forearm like a club. Reversal by Brad Armstrong. Brad started to charge in. That's where he was a little bit foolish, perhaps, and Hansen quickly took advantage of it. Hansen is known as a bone breaker. He has put a lot of men out of wrestling, some of them permanently. Brad Armstrong makes the tag. Mr. Wrestling 2 charges in Wrestling 2 on fire. An arm whip on Ole Anderson. Caught him. Beautiful forearm, and it was, look at this, double teaming before the count, and it is Wrestling 2 exploding with everything that he has against the Stan Hansen. The bad man from Borger, Texas, has got his problems. A side headlock by Mr. Wrestling 2. Hansen trying to break it up, drives Wrestling 2 back into his own corner. Notice the way Anderson quickly tagged up, and Anderson takes advantage of the count. The two of them double teaming Wrestling 2 before the count of four was over. Good move by Wrestling 2. Caught him. Tried to go for the knee, and did you see the way Anderson spun out of the way on that one? You cannot take a thing away from Anderson or Hansen. For men that big, they're exceptionally fast. Good takedown by Wrestling 2 going to a bottom wrist lock. And again, Anderson made the tag. Now, notice the way he's got Wrestling 2 back up against those ring ropes. They double team extremely well. And they do it all within the four count perimeter. Hansen's back already beginning to show the marks of this match. Wrestling 2 back to his feet, now makes the tag. Brad Armstrong charges back into the ring. Armstrong now explodes with a couple of right hands to the midsection. Brad Armstrong caught him, a good drop kick. It's Brad Armstrong now with a side headlock. Look at this strength of this man, Hansen. Had him up. Tremendous souple by Stan Hansen. Armstrong managed to get himself out of there before the count of three. And it is Anderson now continuing to press the advantage on Brad Armstrong. Armstrong fires to the midsection, fires to the rib cage once again. And take a good look at that banner, Georgia Championship Wrestling. We've got a brand new name upcoming in just a couple of weeks. Brand new name upcoming. I'll tell you more about it next week. But I'll give you a clue, we're worldwide. Hansen caught in the midsection by wrestling too, but Anderson retaliating, and we've got all four men in the ring now. All four men, now they're beginning to separate. Front chancery by Ole Anderson, keeping wrestling two tied up. And an impact. Good move by wrestling two. Drives Anderson back into his own corner. Wrestling two makes the tag with Brad Armstrong. Brad Armstrong moves in. And it is now Anderson, arm whip. And caught by Brad Armstrong coming off the ropes. And it is the superstar and the super destroyer out here watching things very carefully. And there you see the superstar Buzz Sawyer suddenly appearing on the scene. There's Tommy Wildfire Rick. There's Buzz Sawyer. And Rick watching things very carefully now. Brad Armstrong in trouble in that corner. And there's Tito Santana, Michael Hayes, Terry Gordy. We've got some very, very interested people here watching this Australian tag team event with a great deal of interest. And it is Brad Armstrong, snapmared to the canvas. Stan Hansen down across the chest of Brad Armstrong, makes the tag with Ole Anderson. Ole Anderson kicks him in the ribcage before the count of four. Brad Armstrong fires back. And it's Brad Armstrong beginning to take the measure and now slips through the legs and makes the tag with Wrestling 2. Wrestling 2 in there now. We've got a pair of six are going between Wrestling 2. And Ole Anderson, Stan Hansen's out there. Now Brad Armstrong's back out there. We've got all four men in the ring. And we've got a Donnybrook going now. A pair of six with all four of them out there. Anderson caught. And now it is Hansen being caught. Wait a second. Superstar. Michael Hayes just charged the ring. The referee's calling for the belt. And we've got a battle royal going on now. Andre the Giant. Andre the Giant just appeared and we've got a full-scale battle royal. Andre the Giant clearing the ring. And what a fair six battle royal. You talk about wild action. We've got it here. And they're ringing the bell, trying desperately to get order restored. And they're battling every way but loose. They're going every way but loose now. And let me just take a moment to remind all of you, of course, there will be wrestling tonight in Jackson. Tomorrow afternoon in Chattanooga, there'll be wrestling Tuesday in Danielsville and Thursday in Baxley and Thomasville, Friday in Jasper. Don't forget Monday in Gainesville at the Stephen O'Connell Center. Tickets are still available.
All right, Jackson. Jackson. Superstar, it's going to start tonight in Jackson, pal. I'm going to get you in Jackson, Florida.
Jackson,
Georgia.
Georgia. Jackson, Georgia is the place. And, of course, tomorrow night, get your tickets now for the Omni tomorrow night. Well, our time is completely gone here, and we're finally getting some law and order restored in the ring. But, brother, out
heavyweight championship, and that promises to be very exciting.
I think Mr. Orndorff is saying he might want to try him out for size, but right now he's got his mind on one thing, and that is the Super Destroyer. This match, then, one fall.
with a 15-minute time limit. And obviously coming out to scout Paul Orndorff is a man who's very interested in the National Heavyweight Championship himself, Buzz Sawyer.
Yeah, this is the man right here that plans on holding that belt after the Omni's all done and over with. I'm out here, I'm going to watch Super Destroyer, and I'm going to watch Paul Orndorff, and we'll just see what happens.
Top wrist lock now by Paul Orndorff on the Super Destroyer. Orndorff, known as the Brandon Bull. Outstanding athlete, the Super Destroyer. I don't know his origin, but I can tell you this. I've watched him compete for a number of years. Big man, 6'3", 6'4", 270, 260, around in there. Side headlock on Orndorff. Hip lock takedown, and it was Orndorff very quickly getting the head scissors on the Super Destroyer. And again, an excellent opportunity to see the muscular conformation and definition of one Paul Orndorff.
That's right, those legs got to be pretty strong. Played pro football, college football, now professional wrestling. That's what it's all about. We're going to see what kind of stamina that those legs have in this match here with the Super Destroyer.
And, of course, this match being one fall with a 15-minute time limit rather than our regular 10-minute time limit. As I've said so many times before, when you get a chance, no matter where you live across this great country of ours, when you get a chance to get out and see wrestling live at the arenas, we invite you to do so. It's a great, great sport, and it becomes an electric feeling. There's no question about that. The Super Destroyer now eyeing Orndorff, perhaps with a little bit more respect now.
That's right. You know, Orndorff knows the first star he's out here watching. You think that might have a little psychological advantage on him or what, Mr. Sawyer?
Well, Mr. Sawyer, I don't know. I would think that as long as you're over here at the desk and not near the ring, that perhaps he will be able to bypass that situation. And obviously that is where you belong. If you want to scout the man, you belong over in this section. But it's Orndorff now with an armbar, and it is now the Super Destroyer who would like very much to break the situation loose if he can. Good. Deep move inside into a standing fireman carry. Well executed by the Super Destroyer. Reversal there by Paul Orndorff into a hammerlock, and then comes down on the biceps and triceps with that knee. And so the Super Destroyer beginning to, and he chicken wings the arm.
Well, I'd like to see him be able to do that to mine. There ain't no man walking can put my arm behind my back like that. You know something, these people right here out here watching this match now, they kind of remind me of the people up north in Michigan and West Virginia and Ohio. That's right, Buzz Sawyer, the Wonder Boy. You're going to be able to see him up there. And I can't wait if it's against someone like Paul Orndorff or Tommy Rich. And right now, Paul Orndorff's the dog on my list.
Again, comments from Buzz Sawyer. Sawyer, I might add, of course, went to the Nationals in high school competition and turned pro at a very young age, way ahead of most people, and has done extremely well, and held the National Heavyweight Championship at one point in his career. Of course, the tournament will decide all of that. High head toss now by Orndorff into a lateral press. Out before the count.
You know, I hope in that tournament comes right down to me and Orndorff, because I'm going to enjoy rubbing his nose in the mat. I'm going to enjoy punishing him and showing him what a real wrestler is.
Well, of course, in a one-night round-robin tournament, you might end up wrestling against the magnificent Morocco. You might face Ole Anderson.
And I might face Roddy Piper.
That's a fact, too, as a matter of fact. It could certainly happen. That National Heavyweight Championship tournament attracting names from all over the country.
Obviously, you've missed my point, Mr. Soley. I don't care who I have to wrestle. That's what I'm doing out here, watching this match, learning what's going on, watching people's moves, because you know as well as I do, Gordon, it only takes one mistake.
That's right. The count of three can become very, very quick.
Oh, Paul's in a little trouble now, isn't he? Yeah.
Orndorff in trouble, no question about that, and the Super Destroyer continuing to press that advantage. And Orndorff, who had been moving him very effectively earlier, now finding himself on the receiving end from the Super Destroyer. Good reversal by Orndorff. Orndorff closes in once again. And it's the Super Destroyer getting their shoulders off the mat before the count of three, however. Orndorff, inside step over on the arm. And that wrenches the deltoid muscles and really gives that upper shoulder a lot of problems. Full arm drag and twist now into a... a shoulder bar, I suppose, would be the best definition of that. And Orndorff again beginning to diversify
his attack. I can show you how to get out of that, old Gordon, but I'm not going to. I'm going to wait and save my talent. He can get up here and show everybody what he's got, but Buzz Sawyer is just going to hold back.
Well, your name was one of those that could have very easily been drawn, and it might have been you and Orndorff, or it could have been you and the Super Destroyer. So.
Well, he's just lucky it was the Super Destroyer instead of Buzz Sawyer. That'd be awful embarrassing getting beat right here on national TV, wouldn't it?
You, of course, claim never to have lost on.
Never in my life have I ever lost. Not just on TV, never in a match, nowhere in the world. But Sawyer's undefeated. Talking about the national title, he cheated when he won that.
I see.
You want to sound real nice, two-time national champion, Buzz Sawyer.
A very confident Buzz Sawyer, and it is Paul Orndorff in trouble again.
You better learn what trouble is, because when Sawyer's around, he's going to know what trouble is. The Wonder Boy's here to stay. I want to show these people what a man's made out of.
And it is indeed a snapmare by Super Destroyer, then down across the chest of Paul Orndorff. Count of two, and Orndorff coming up rather slowly. This match beginning to take its toll on both men. Right now, I think we're about seven minutes into the match. And it is Orndorff now caught in a side headlock.
That's called a shortcut, Mr. Soley.
Yes, it is, as a matter of fact. Orndorff.
I myself never use that, but that's what it's called. I just wanted to let you know the terminology of it.
Thank you so very much, Mr. Sawyer. And it is Orndorff continuing to be punished here in the corner by the Super Destroyer. Orndorff in that turnbuckle now. And he continues to punish him. Don't forget, this match is one fall 15, and it is... it is still troubles here with Orndorff now into that turnbuckle, and both of these men really beginning to show the wear and tear of this match thus far.
You know, Gordon, you talk about how good wrestling is on television. Certainly, people can see right now when you have a top-caliber match in the ring that it's even that much better when they go to the arenas or the coliseums. When you've got two great men like Orndorff and the Super D Wrestling, they both know how important it is to come out on top. They know that everything can be riding on this one match. This television goes all over the world. Who wouldn't want to have a win on Channel 17?
No question about that. And, of course, I just mentioned next week we'll be telling you more about the fact that we do have, it will be known as World Championship Wrestling. Interesting to note that Ole Anderson, I have to feel in my own mind, is scouting again, because he, too, has his eye on that National Heavyweight Championship in that round-robin tournament.
You know, amazingly enough, Stan Hansen and I, as world champions, have been belittled by a lot of people claiming that we didn't deserve those titles. Look at that, Orndorff. Come on, Super D.
And it was a Super Destroyer getting the worst of... Oh, caught him coming off the ropes. And he nailed him with that forearm. No, sir. Came away from it very nicely. Came out before the count of three and into a rear chin lock now by the Super Destroyer.
I want to make that comment that the Freebirds and a lot of people have been saying that those national titles are more important than the world belts, especially now since those national belts are representing
countries all over the world. I suppose you might call them international belts. Well, as far as we're concerned, Hanson and myself, we're the best tag team in the world today. But if the people think that those national belts are more important, then I guess maybe we're going to have to do something with those world belts. I haven't figured out yet. Maybe we'll retire them. All I want you to know is that Stan and I are going to make sure that we and everybody else know that we're the greatest tag team in wrestling.
And
it means that we got to go after those national belts, and that's what we'll do.
Fair enough. An open challenge by Ole Anderson, and as this match moves on, I would prefer not to, so please stay with us. I don't want to cut away to a commercial unless we absolutely have to.
You know, Mr. Soli, I'd have to second that opinion. Ole Anderson and Stan Hansen's probably the greatest tag team that ever lived. And I've been fortunate enough to have someone like Ole Anderson take me under his wing. And boy, he's taught me the right things to do. And I tell you what, it's paid off. I've made lots of money. Lots of enemies, but who cares as long as the cash is there, right?
Right, okay. Well, I don't want to cut away to a commercial, but I think we're going to have to. Should a pinfall or a submission hold occur during this commercial break, we will bring it to you in instant replay, but we'll be back. We'll be back in just a moment. And neither man able to score a pinfall or a submission during that time that we were away on a commercial break, but it is Orndorff who is beginning to try and turn the tide now on the Super Destroyer.
Boy, they're really going at it now, Mr. Soli. They missed a little bit at while we were away. Look at Paul Orndorff. You know, I got to say one thing about the man. He's not too smart.
Yeah, but he's got great stamina, great endurance, and...
Take that away from him, but I got a lot better.
Yeah. Nonetheless, I might just point out that this man... Super Destroyer is in a lot of trouble now as Orndorff.
Look at that open fist, right? No, it was a closed fist. That was Paul Orndorff with the closed fist. He's supposed to be Mr. Nice now. Looks like to me he's getting a little rugged out there. You don't think I have anything to do with that, do you?
Mr. Sawyer, I would appreciate it greatly, sir, if you would allow me to continue. We only have a few seconds left in this match, and I would like to, if I may.
It's been your pleasure, man.
Yes, it really has. Orndorff now, and the Super Destroyer, and thus far, neither man able to gain a pinfall or a submission hold, and it is Orndorff driving down on him once again, and it is Orndorff continuing to press the advantage now into a snapmare. And it is the Super Destroyer gaining his feet once again. Now the Super Destroyer using a forearm in Orndorff. That's the inside of the fist, and that is within the legal parameters. Orndorff continues to punish the Super Destroyer, and neither man able to gain a pinfall or a submission hold. And the Super Destroyer now, the lateral press, but Orndorff powers out before the count. Orndorff clubbing away at the side of the jaw. What a fantastic match. And the bell has rung. The time limit has expired. The time limit has expired. Neither man able to gain a pinfall or a submission hold. But the Super Destroyer outside the ring, obviously tremendously tired from this match, and understandably so. We'll take a look at that again in the closing seconds. Orndorff caught him, and notice the way those fists are, that last one just grazing the jaw. Now Orndorff catching him once again to the side of the jaw, putting him down to the canvas, but could not get the pinfall or the submission, so neither man able to gain a pinfall. The time limit did expire in this match between these two men, the Super Destroyer and Paul Orndorff. It was determined at that time that these two men would come back and meet today on this hour of Georgia Championship Wrestling. One fall with the 1 hour time limit or whatever television time is remaining. And it will be this match to determine which of these two men is the better man. However, the ultimate decision for The National Heavyweight Championship belt that Les Thatcher is holding right now will be determined by the tournament that's upcoming. Let me introduce first then, at 265 pounds from parts unknown, the Super Destroyer, the Super Destroyer. At 243 pounds from Brandon, Florida, the Brandon Bull, Paul Orndorff. Paul Orndorff. One fall, television time remaining. Okay, Paul Orndorff sizing up the Super Destroyer. These two men, the bell has rung. These two men wrestled to a 15-minute draw last week, and we're getting a chance. Orndorff, of course, Les, as you know, gave up the National Heavyweight Championship.
That's right, Gordon, in pursuit of the world title held by Ric Flair. But, of course, once again, as you've mentioned, and I've already mentioned, so much emphasis has been put on this national title belt, and, of course, that tournament is going to be of key importance.
There's certainly no question about that, and it would be interesting with some of the contestants who have already entered that tournament. There's no telling how those pairings could go. It could be Orndorff and the Iron Sheik, or it could be the Iron Sheik and Buzz Sawyer, or it could be Ole Anderson and Roddy Piper. There's no telling how that thing might work out.
I think it's indicative of this title that every match is going to be a great one, no matter who draws who, Gordon.
That is certainly the truth, and it is a good move by the Super Destroyer. Back leg trip, and look at Orndorff now trying to cross over with that leg. Trying to escape, turning to his man. Good move by Orndorff, good defensive move. And back into the ropes, Orndorff back on his feet in a clean break.
You know, I think Paul Orndorff is one of the most complete young wrestlers I've seen in many years, Gordon. This young fella has it all, power, speed, finesse, and, of course, he's with a man now who carries a phenomenal amount of weight with great ease.
He does. He has a remarkable speed for his size and weight. Orndorff now locks in with a head scissors, and, of course, Orndorff will use his legs consistently throughout a match. He is, well, an all-round wrestler from that respect, as Les mentioned just a moment ago. And again, Orndorff is able to roll free, and both men back on their feet once again.
Super Destroyer being very cautious of Orndorff. Orndorff, a good move there, Gordon.
Excuse me, Les Thatcher. I'm out here watching Paul Orndorff.
The voice of Buzz Sawyer, I might add.
That's right. Well, I don't think you have to tell anybody that, Gordon Soley, because everybody knows the voice of Buzz Sawyer. They don't even have to see my pretty face. And you, of all people, know what I'm doing out here. I'm out watching Paul Orndorff because I hope when it comes down to the tournament, I don't care if it's the first round, the second round, or in the last, I'm going to get Orndorff. I heard you call him from Brandon, Florida, the Bull. I'm going to show you what a bull is.
Buzz Sawyer, who obviously keeps scouting at all times and has some very strong personal feelings about Paul Orndorff. Sawyer, of course, from St. Petersburg, Florida, with an outstanding good drop toehold by Orndorff, has the Super D down, but it is both men back on their feet once again. Very.
That's one thing I'm good at, staying on my feet, Mr. Soley. And Paul Orndorff's going to find all about that.
Orndorff now with a hammerlock. He's winged it slightly, winged the arm slightly on Super Destroyer. Now up into the, basically sort of a variation of a shoulder bar, and now they're into the ring ropes. Referee Nick Patrick calling for the break, and it was a Super Destroyer, a clubbing forearm on the break, then the base of the elbow on the break. And a snap mare that takes Orndorff back to the canvas, and he has been stunned.
Well, it kind of looks that way, don't it? You know, you got all the top competitors in the world right here on World Championship Wrestling. And Mr. Soley, you have the pleasure and the opportunity to be able to stand to my immediate left and be able to have the sensational feeling that Buzz Sawyer, the next national champion, is standing here talking to you. And you think things have been rough, I'm going to get a whole lot rougher.
All right, some very confident comments from Buzz Sawyer, but comments that I feel very assuredly that he can back up. He has proven himself to be a double tough competitor. He has held the National Heavyweight Championship, as has Paul Orndorff. Orndorff now beginning to punish a headbutt by the Super Destroyer. Catches Orndorff, doubles him up again. McPatrick checking to make sure those were belt line and above, and it is Orndorff. The knee driven into the side of the rib cage that time. Got him around that short rib, and now picks up on a bear hug. And so it is obvious that the Super Destroyer trying to take away the airflow, the oxygen input into the brain, and slow Orndorff down.
You know, I feel when I'm out here watching Paul Orndorff, I feel like I just want to go crazy, Mr. Soley, because the man makes me sick. I can't wait to get him in the square circle, because the people's going to see the most brutal wrestling match that they've ever seen. And, baby, I'm going to be hopping and popping.
Buzz Sawyer.
And I know it's been your pleasure, Mr. Soley. I think I'll go back and get away from all these ignorant people out here and watch it on the monitor. And it's been your pleasure, I'm sure.
A diamond in the rough, Buzz Sawyer. And it is a good move by Orndorff. Good high hip toss. Has a Super Destroyer back on the canvas once again. And some very interesting comments from Buzz Sawyer. This match now, in case you've just tuned in, is one fall with television time remaining, or approximately 60 minutes. Depending on the progress, of course. We will be, obviously, should this match go for any great distance in time, we'll be cutting away to commercials when necessary. And should it end before the hour, obviously we do have standby matches. Super Destroyer, at this stage I would say that both of these men, outstanding athletes, both of them. And no matter where you lived, if you were to get a chance to see these men in live action, that is certainly, both of these men are certainly main event competitors. Good arm bar by Paul Orndorff, and he's keeping the pressure. Notice the way those deltoids are being pulled and stretched in the shoulder of the Super Destroyer. Nice to have some folks visiting here at our television sports arena. Have them here today from all over the country, including some good folks from Charleston, West Virginia, and from Lima, Ohio. An outstanding match thus far. And it is the Super Destroyer now moving up against Orndorff. Has Orndorff up against the ring ropes. The referee up against the turnbuckle referee. The Super Destroyer caught him. And the Super Destroyer now using that high knee lift very effectively. Orndorff explodes now. Orndorff explodes. And he may have the Super Destroyer. And boy, if there's any way, let's not go to any commercial now. Let's stay with it. Let's stay with the action now, because we've got some great action going on as Orndorff really unloading some heavy artillery now on the Super Destroyer. And it is the Super Destroyer trying to retaliate, but Orndorff scoring very, very effectively. And now the Super Destroyer, arm whip deck into that far turnbuckle. Paul Orndorff on top of him. Brandon Bull missed that time with a flying dropkick, and the Super Destroyer catches Paul Orndorff. And, well, I was hoping we wouldn't have to break away, but we're going to have to break away. We're going to have to break away. Should there be a pinfall or a submission during this commercial break, we'll have it for you on instant replay. We'll be back. We'll be back, hopefully, in just a moment with continuing action in this match. Neither man has been able to score a pinfall or a submission hold. And it has been Paul Orndorff caught in that rear chin lock, but Orndorff now battling his way back to his feet, firing with everything that he's got. Beautiful dropkick, well executed by the Brandon Bull. No, sir, the Super Destroyer has that leg over the bottom ring rope, and the referee then calls for the break. The Super Destroyer smashed into the new logo on the mat, as you can see out there. A near fall, World Championship Wrestling. And it is the Super Destroyer back on his feet once again. All right, they're back into the turnbuckle. Referee Nick Patrick calling for the break. And Orndorff lashes out with a foot and then catches the Super Destroyer. Drives a hard right hand into the midsection. Paul Orndorff, inside armbar now on the Super Destroyer. You can hear the comment as the referee asked the Super Destroyer if he wanted to concede, and he said nope. And Orndorff continues to apply even more pressure. Super Destroyer battling his way back to his feet. And the Super Destroyer now, hard right hand, and one a rabbit punch back of that. Orndorff firing back. Arm whip into the far. Ooh, Orndorff charging. Super Destroyer got to one side, and Orndorff caught his shoulder and his arm in that turnbuckle. And the Super Destroyer continues to press his advantage. Orndorff explodes. Orndorff catching with a couple of hard right hands. Orndorff has him up. High backdrop by Paul Orndorff. Orndorff crashes down across the chest with that knee. And the Super Destroyer again slides away from a possible three count. Orndorff, a high hip toss into a lateral press. No, sir. Again, the Super Destroyer slips away. Orndorff has him up, a full body slam into a lateral press again and again. The referee checking their shoulders, only a count of two. And it's Orndorff now. Caught to an inside cradle. Reversed. He reversed an inside cradle. Beautifully executed. Beautifully executed reversal on an inside cradle. And the Brandon Bull, completely and totally elated as he executed a perfect reverse on an inside cradle. Caught his man, and the Super Destroyer claiming only a two count. Claiming only a two count. He is claiming only a two count, but it was in fact a three.
Johnny Rich, because I know how concerned he is about his cousin, Tommy Wildfire Rich, and I know that you're wishing him the very best. He's got a very tough match coming up.
That's right, Mr. Sully. You know, we were out here a while ago watching this match, and Morocco, you know, he's out there. Sure, he had an easy time with Jimmy Powell, but Jimmy Powell, not taking nothing away from him, he just doesn't have the experience as Morocco does. But tomorrow night in the Omni, Morocco, you're going to face somebody that does have the experience, and somebody's going to take care of you, buddy, maybe once and for all, I hope.
Well, of course, I can only say that when you get a man like Morocco with the intent...
I'm getting a little bit sick. You out here blowing all the riches and everything else. Everything. You tell him the Tommy Rich is going to come. Where the heck is Tommy Rich?
No,
I was standing right there. You, Sully, everybody, you're telling how Tommy Rich runs 60 miles a week. Big deal.
He'll be there tomorrow night.
Yeah.
There tomorrow night, buddy. That's right.
Well,
that's right.
I'll tell you what. Johnny, do me a favor. Please leave, Johnny. No, I don't want...
Sully, a couple weeks ago, I apologized. A lot of people think it was an accident when you got hit. But let me tell you right now, I never heard, in all the years I've been associated with you, I never heard you tell anybody. I was the first one to reverse the figure four ever. I haven't wrestled NWA World Champion since 1950. Yeah, you never get on Piper's case. You never done nothing about Piper. All you ever want to do is just get out of here. You never done, all you ever say is Tommy Rich. I hear about Dusty Rhodes. I hear about Roddy Piper. What a fine athletic background he's got. I hear, take a walk, will you? Everything else. I said, you know something? Hey, you.
Oh, now just a
little bit. I've got an officer.
Undisputed man in the ring, whatever kind of match it may be. And these people around here are going to see this. The Tommy Riches, I see this great talent. This is the greatest talent in all the world. Right here, Channel 17, Worldwide Wrestling. And I understand national belt is up for grabs. And I'm going to grab it. I don't care who I have to go through first. And like I said, the Riches, I don't care about them. The Paul Orndorff, I don't care about him. Dusty Rhodes. You know, I could go on naming hundreds of different great athletes, but you're going to find out this Russian is...